Hello students, welcome to my channel Python Ki Bhasha. In the previous video, we learned about functions used to fetch data from result set. In this video, we will discuss parameterized query, how you formatting the query string in a parameterized queries. If you are new to my channel or those who have not subscribed, please subscribe, and those who wants to see my previous video, the links are given in the descriptions. If you like my video, please press the like button and share. For further notification, press the bell icon. So let's start the today's. Suppose I need to select from the database or table some particular elements depending upon some parameters. In that case, we need to make use some percentage formatting, which is two ways, that is old style formatting and the new style string formatting. In the old style formatting, the general form is F percentage V. F is what? Templating the string. That is a string time, whatever you are passing the queries, that is an F. And V is a value, which value you want to extract from the database, and that value is in the tuple forms. I mean, give an example, select star from EMP data where salary or cell greater than percentage S means it is a string, the whole it is a string. And string means what? Percentage S means what? Salary greater than that values. And the value is passed in the V parameters. That is, I am passing this parameter, that is 30,000. So you can pass, whenever you do the queries, different queries, you can give the queries in a formatting way. So in this way, the old style can be implemented in select statements. And the new style is what? String template with formatting, without formatting, using the dot operators. What is that? Same thing, I'm giving an example, select star from EMP data where salary greater than that parameter in a curly brackets, two curly brackets, and this is old style is percentage of S, it is a string format, and it is a curly bracket that you put the string in a curly brackets, or EMP name is equal to curly bracket within a single quotation, means name is a string. So string must you have to quoted in a single quotations in Python. Then dot format is a function that you are passing that parameter 1000. So 1000 value is what? Salary. And niha is what? It is a name of EMP name. So there are two ways to formatting the queries. That is a old style. You see how that old style is written, and new style, you see how that dot format operation, format functions pass the parameters. Let's execute the program in Python IDL. So I am written the program. First I am importing the connector. So import mysql.connector, and inside that connect functions I have a four parameters. The first parameter is host, localhost, username, that is by default is root. Password by default is root, but I am changing the password, that is 1234. That's why I am putting 1234. And database I am using today, that is EMP2. So the database is connected or not, so you are checking that functions is connected functions. If the database is connected, there is no error that successfully connected. Else if that some error is occurred, that unsuccessful connected the databases. Then next step is to create the cursor. Now I am taking a cursor object, cur is equal to db.cursor functions. You can pass the queries in old style. Okay, I am passing the parameter, that is a select star from emp data. So my table is emp data. You see emp data table is what are the fields are available in MySQL. You see that I am using that ucmp to desc emp data to see the structure of a table. Now that emp data table, I have emp number, emp name, employee salary and mobile numbers. Now this database is available in MySQL. Now I am using this that database emp data in SQL. I am passing the query that where emp salary greater than percentage s, s means string. I am passing the string. Condition is what? Emp salary greater than string s means what? What is that value? Percentage value is passing that 30,000. Clear? Then whatever the datas are satisfy the conditions, then I am fetching all the records. The last video we are discussing that how to fetch the one by one records, many records. So I am using that for loop. I am extracting the one records from I am using also row count function. How many rows are fetched, it will display. Now let's run this program. You see, successfully connected, and greater than 30,000, I have three records, that is 60,000, 70,000 and 90,000. And how many records are fetched? That is a total number of records are fetched, that is 3. Now you see, you can pass these queries also in another way. Suppose I am taking a variable. Query is equal to, suppose I am passing the whole queries that whole queries, you copy it, control C. And in this parameters you can pass just to write query. So in this way you can pass the queries also. Save it, run that program. You see the same records are fetches. In another way you can fetch that, once you are taking a variable, inside that variables you are passing the parameters, passing the queries, and that variable you pass in execute functions. This is a another way how you pass that queries. Another way you can take the salary from the users also. So I am taking that, suppose I am taking salary is equal to int, you input that values, input, enter the salary, and take the value from the users, enter the salaries, that you can pass query is equal to this query functions. Now you pass, you are not passing the static value, you are passing the runtime values, salaries, and putting that's a semicolon salary comma, that means it is a tuple. I am passing that one element, that's why that, because that query is in a old query is passing in a tuple form, that I am putting that semicolon, that number of parameterized queries you can pass in this string also. So you put this, run this program. Now you see, enter the salary. Suppose I am taking 30,000. Now you see, at the time of runtime, you are input the salaries, and whatever the condition is satisfied, then it fetches the three records that the total number of rows is three. So in this different ways, you can pass the parameters also. You can also pass the multiple queries. So I am passing that query select star from EMP data where EMP salary greater than percentage of S. That salary is 30,000. I am putting the last previous program. Suppose I am writing and EMP name equal to the name is a character type, you have to put a single quotations, percentage S. Percentage S, quotation close, and you can pass the per, you can input that values also. Suppose I am taking a name is equal to putting that also, inputting the name also, name is equal to input enter the names name also, and you pass that parameter in the name. Here I am passing the multiple queries, select star from EMP data where EMP salary greater than that, and EMP name also equal to whatever you are inputting the values. Now you run this program. You see, successfully connected. I'm putting the salary, suppose 30,000, and the name is asking name, suppose I am putting in here. You see that only one record is fetches, that the salary is 30,000 and the name equal to Neha. Clear? Salary is greater than equal to 30,000 and the name is Neha, only one record is fetches, that salary is 60,000 rupees. So in this way, you can pass the old formatting queries in the Python IDL. Now you can pass the new format. Suppose I am written query is equal to, suppose I am passing the parameters, what is that? Format new, select star from EMP data where EMP salary, then suppose you are that string format. Now new format is a curly bracket format. So putting that curly bracket, and I am putting the multiple conditions also. EMP name equal to, name is a string type, so put in a single quotations and put a curly bracket, then closing that single quotation dot format, the new style is a format, and you are passing that salary. What is there? You are inputting salary comma name. Select star from this. Suppose messaging that formats. I'm putting this in the message. Now we execute the new style. Run this program. Select star from employee data where EMP salary, and then this format EMP salary greater than this, add EMP name greater than this, putting double quotations. Now you see successfully connected. Enter the salary. Suppose I am putting 30,000. Name is suppose Neha. Salary is not defined. You see why salary is not defined. Input salary. Format salary comma dot format EMP cell greater than equal to percentage s. This EMP is format salary. Okay, salary is s is a capital letters. Here now you put this, run it. Asking that salary, suppose I am putting 30,000. Now name is suppose Neha, and it is putting, you see the new style format also displaying the record whatever the condition, the salary is 30,000 and then greater than 30,000 and name is Neha. So in this way you can pass the SQL query command in old style and new style also. In a particular element, depending upon some part of parameters, in that case we need to make the same percentage formatting, which is called old style formatting. And the another way is what without formatting is called new style, and it is used as a dot operations. It is used as a dot format operation. It is also called a new style operation. So in this way you can pass the queries in a different formatting ways. So any doubts you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you. Have a nice day.